All over the world, everyone knows Halloween as the night when witches howl and ghosts scream on every corner. This is the night the dead walk and restless spirits stalk the edges of our dreams. It's the night that old Betty Davidson takes Robert Burns on a journey from his death to his birth. A journey that visits the bard's most loved songs and poems and traces the origins of his masterpiece, Tam O Shanter. When Chapman Billies leave the street and druthy neighbours meet, as market days are drawing late and folks begin to tack the gate, while we sit boozing at the nappy and getting foo and unca happy, we think not on the lang Scots miles, the mosses, waters, slaps and stiles that lie between us and our hame, where sits our sulky, sullen dame, gathering her brews like gathering storm, nursing her wrath to keep it warm. This truth found honest Tam O'Shanter, as he frae airy night did canter, all there whom ne'er a tune surpasses, for honest men and bonny lasses. Oh, Tam, had thou been sae wise as ta'en thy ain wife Kate's advice, she told thee weel thou was a skellum, a blethering, blustering, drunken blellum, that frae November till October, a market day, thou was na sober. The ilka melder with the miller, thou sat as long as thou had siller, that every naig was cad a shoe on, the smith in thee got roaring foo on, that at the Lord's house, even on Sunday, thou drank wi' Kurt and Jean till Monday. She prophesied that late or soon thou would be found deep drowned in doon, or catch wi' warlocks in the murk by Alloway's old haunted kirk. Oh, gentle dames, it gars me greet to think how many counsels sweet, how many lengthened sage advices the husband from the wife despises. But to our tale. A market night, Tam had got planted anchor right, fast by an ingle blazing finely with reaming swats that drank divinely, and at his elbow suitor Johnny, his ancient, trusty, druthy crony. Tam loved him like a very brother. They'd been getting through for weeks together. The night drave on with sangs and clatter, and aye the ale was growing better. The suitor told his queerest stories. The landlord's laugh was ready chorus. The landlady and Tam grew gracious with favours secret, sweet and precious. The storm without might rare and rustle. Tam did not mind the storm a whistle. Gair mad to see a man sae happy and drooned himsel among the nappy. Kings may be blessed, but Tam was glorious, our Oriel's life victorious. But pleasures are like poppies spread. You seize the flower, its bloom is shed. Or like the snow falls in the river, a moment white then melts forever. Or like the Borealis race that flit there, you can point their place. Or like the rainbow's lovely form, a vanishing amid the storm. Nae man can tether time nor tide. The hour approaches, Tam maun ride. That hour o' night's black arch the keystay, and that dreary hour he mounts his beast in, and sick a night he tacks the road in, as ne'er poor sinner was abroad in. The wind blew as it was blown its last, the rattling showers rose on the blast, the speedy gleams of darkness swallowed, loud, deep and lang the thunder bellowed. That night a child might understand, the deil had business on his hand.
Like coming case. should all be hovels for women. Rude Michael presses the shot the dead in their last dresses, and by some warlocks and witches in a dance. Nay, Cortillion, Boris Taylor, with short pipes, jigs, strands, man, and our son, Turkey, where to drink, he asked to get that music, whispers, charges, screwed the pipes, and got them scurled to roof and drafters, oh dear. Remember Tam O Shanter's mare.